Hi, in this video we are going to discuss about the classical problems of synchronization. Classical problems used to test newly proposed synchronization schemes. We'll be taking two problems here to discuss and understand how the synchronization among all processes is achieved. So first we'll be taking bounded buffer problem. That is the producer-consumer problem. Say you have a circular buffer and of n slot. So n is 1, that means buffer size is 1, and n is 10, buffer size is 10. So there are two pointers, one is in and out. So both points to empty slot, that is in point to empty slot and out point to filled slot. So here producer keeps on producing an item till it reaches the size of the buffer, the maximum size. Say if it is 10, it can store up to 10 items. Consumer keeps consuming an item from the buffer, and it should be synchronized in such a way it produces the full buffer, and it consumer consumes an item and it provides the empty buffer to producer. So in a system there are n number of producers, n number of consumers. Say if P1 is producing an buffer, and C1 consumer may consuming an item and producing again a buffer, empty buffer. So if you analyze the problem, as I said, the producer deposits info to buff of n, and the consumer retrieves information from buff of out. So in and out must be advanced. So in is shared among producer, out is shared among consumers. So here if buffer is full, we should stop producer to not to produce. It should be blocked. Similarly, if buffer is empty, we should stop or block consumers. Else it may be overflow or underflow. So if you see using semaphore, how this problem can be solved? So we need a semaphore to protect the buffer first. So first buffer should be protected. Like I have a locker, I placed some gold within the locker. It first, that is a buffer. Say if I have a gold chain, I have placed in the locker, and that locker must be locked. So for that we need, that is the buffer where I can place the number of gold items. So that is locked. So we need a semaphore to protect the buffer, one, and second semaphore to block the producer to access it, and similarly one more semaphore to block the consumer, right? So one is where I can lock the buffer, and another one is block producer and consumer. So we need three semaphores. What are those semaphores? If you see, the semaphores is one is not full and not empty and mutex. So these are the three semaphores. This is to protect the buffer, right? Mutex is to protect the buffer, that is only one is accessing it, and this is to either block the not full and not empty. So these are the two semaphores we use it. So for not full, in the case where it can produce an item, not empty where it can consume an item. So here, that is the n is the buffer size, zero is it reached zero, right? That is initially zero, right? Not full, that is n, and not empty is zero initially, the values. So now, so here producer wait buffer not full, right? So this red shows invoking wait operation. If you remember semaphore, there are two operations, wait and signal. All green or signal and red or wait. So what we are doing is, say as a producer, so wait on, say if I want to place my gold coin into my locker. Locker is a buffer. So If I want to place my gold item, I want to place a gold coin into my locker. Locker is a buffer and item is a gold coin. So what I do is, I want to acquire the locker which is not full. So wait on not full. I am acquiring the locker. Then lock the buffer. Wait on not full, that is empty buffer. In locker there is no coins, gold coins. Then wait on buffer, that is lock. Then I put my coin, then I put my gold coin. Once it is done, I unlock the buffer. I unlock the buffer. Then I unlock, that is signal on. I invoke a signal. Again I invoke a signal. So what I do is I just unlock it. And I say that is buffer is not empty. Now it is notified to consumer. So consumer will invoke wait on empty, that is not empty, right? Because I have produced the buffer with gold coin, which is not empty. The buffer is not empty. So consumer will invoke wait on not empty, then wait on lock, because no other consumer is allowed to enter into critical section, not allowed to take the gold coin. So wait on not empty, wait on lock, take the gold coin, then again unlock the buffer, then again buffer is not full. Now it says buffer is empty, so notify to producer. So this is how it synchronizes among the number of producers and consumers. So if you see the solution for this, so as I said, there are three semaphores, and this is a producer code, this is the consumer code. So you can see now not full. Producer want to produce it, so it need a not full buffer. So not full, wait on not full, then lock. This is wait on mutex, that is lock. So produce an item till n, then signal on mutex, that is lock is unlocked, then signal on not empty, that is full, not empty, that is full buffer. Then consumer invoke wait on not empty, lock, consume all the item, then invoke signal on mutex, that is unlock the lock, that is unlock, then not full, that is empty is produced, notify to producer. So this is how the producer consumer problem is synchronized among each other, and the way how it can produce an item, the producer full buffer, and consume an item, produce the empty buffer, right? I hope this makes you very clear. Now we'll move on to next problem. So before that, if you have any questions, right? So the way you write the code, if you change the code, for example, in a producer code, wait on mutex, you acquire a lock, then wait on not full, you first lock it, acquire a lock, and wait on not full. The order is changed now. You lock it and wait on not full, that is empty buffer. You produce an item. Now again, signal on not empty. That means it produces a full buffer, but here it is lock. That is the order is changed. So signal on the lock. So here, for that is again, what you are doing is you are locking it and unlock it. So you are changing the order, that leads to again deadlock, right? That leads to a deadlock. So one may be trying to acquire before the item has been produced, because you made a signal on not empty. So it says other consumer will be trying to acquire this and lock for consume. So this change the order of the code, that leads to a deadlock. Now coming into reader writer problem. So you have two groups of processes, one is reader and writer. So reader can read simultaneously. One reader is doing read operation, another reader is also allowed to read. but not doing write operation. But only one writer can write at the time. When a writer is writing, no reader is allowed, no writer is allowed. Right? So that is a problem. So if I start reading, say you have the whiteboard. On whiteboard, some content is displayed, and all one can read or all can read. Nothing is going to happen with the data. That is common to all. And say if I am writing, if I asking other people to writing on the board, what will happen? Again, data inconsistency happen. So when reader is doing read operation, readers can be allowed. No write operation is allowed. When writer is doing, no writer, no reader is allowed to do read or write operation. So that is what. So we need a semaphore to block readers if writer is writing, and we need a semaphore when reader is doing read operation. Similarly, other readers can also allow to do read operation, not write operation. So here you can see the reader and writer. Again, red shows the wait operation is invoked, and green shows the signal operation is invoked. So first, if you see the reader, when reader comes in, if I am the first reader, I maintain a counter variable, that is count, reader count. So initially it's going to be zero. When first reader enters, that is invoking a wait operation for doing read operation, first reader, if it is a first reader, the count is incremented by 1. Then I am the first reader, if yes, I can invoke wait on write. Can notice I can invoke wait on write. Then this is a signal. The signal is given for other readers. So first I am entering as a reader for doing read operation. The counter variable is incremented by 1, and I am acquiring lock on write. So no other readers is allowed to do write or writer to do write operation. So that is what happening here. I give signal to all readers. So I will be doing read data, and next reader will also do read data, next reader. So all readers will be doing read operation. Now while leaving, so first reader comes, that is invoke wait operation, because this wants to leave the from reading operation. So invoke wait and comes out from the read operation, signal again wait, again reader will be coming out. So for every time the reader counter variable is decremented. So when I am the last reader, so what will happen is I will be giving a signal to writer that all readers have done read operation. So there are no readers and no writers. Now coming to writer. So when there is a writer, no reader is allowed. It's very clear. So only one writer can be allowed. So wait on write semaphore, doing write operation, signal. That's it. So writing operation is done. So that will be notified to reader, so the reader can do read operation, or notified to writer itself, so writer can do write operation, whatever it is. But only one writer is allowed to do write operation. So the solution here you can see. So as I said, semaphore mutex is one, and write mutex is one, and read count is initially it's going to be zero. Right? So in read, so mutex on wait, that is wait on mutex, that is acquiring a lock. If so, reader count is incremented. If I am the first reader, I invoke wait on write mutex, that is lock on write. Right? Imagine I am a reader and invoking lock on lock on mutex, and reader count is incremented from 0 to 1. If it is a 1, I am the first reader, then acquiring lock on write. So no write operation can be performed until I release, because I am the first reader. Then signal on mutex, I am releasing the lock. So no writer is allowed, no writer is allowed because I have the lock, but readers can be allowed. So read count will be incremented by 1, again next reader it becomes 2. So this condition is invalid for that from reader 2 onwards. So it perform, all readers can perform read operation. And say for one reader it invoking a lock on that is mutex, and is coming out of the read operation. So until reaches to 0, when it reaches to 0, I will be releasing lock on write, then I will be releasing the lock on mutex. So once it is done, it is invoking to writer. So writer can invoke a wait on write semaphore and doing write operation and signal it. So only writer can do write operation. I hope this solution makes you very clear in understanding about reader writer problem. So if any clarification, please do comment. I hope this makes you very clear about the classical examples. Thank you.